limited edition Elite One. Right joystick drifting, right trigger slightly sticking. Let's see if we can fix this one. Right. Left trigger feels good, sounds nice. Yeah, right trigger's sticking a little bit because it's hitting the shell. Seems to do a bit of sideways movement on that. There is on that one as well. We'll check that out. Let's get the tester on the go. Let's get some sticks on there. Left stick. Perfect. Oh, right stick, yeah. 18, minus 18, 19. Yeah, that's well off. That's fully right. Left, up, down, right. Just over halfway it goes. So yeah, that's knackered. Plus it feels really weak. So yeah, that right stick is dead. D-pad. X button feels sticky. Start and select feel a bit mushy. Right bumper feels and works perfect. Same with the left bumper. Left trigger, fine. Right trigger works fine, but it's just grinding on that side. See, it's touching. See the gap there? It's just no gap. But it works. Let's do these buttons. Yep. 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 Okay, so we've got right stick, X button, trigger. So as you can see from that, usually I end up doing more to these pads than the customer actually realises. So for instance, I'm going to be looking at the rubber buttons here, plus cleaning out whatever schmoo is stuck in there. So yep, let's get to it. Are off. chassis off. Take out the analog board, and a piece of black plastic has fell out. I don't know what that is. Audio socket. So let's have a look at this trigger then. Or was it the right trigger? Let's get rid of these bumpers. Now there's look, okay. Okay. So there's no brakes. Ah, yes, there is. Yep. So, can you see it? That's bust there completely. That anchor point has completely gone. There you go. Completely gone. So it's going to need a new inner chassis. Let's see if I have a spare. Okay, so I've got a chassis here which looks to be perfectly fine. I just need to replace that trigger, so let's get rid of that motor for a sec. Let's get this stripped down. This is going to be quite an involved repair. There's your problem on that X button. That looks like Coca-Cola. Okay, so we need left trigger. These pins come out in this direction. Yep. Press that pin in. Which isn't going in. Like it should. There we go, it's going. That's about as much force as I want to give it. It's not 100% home, but it should be good enough. It ain't going anywhere. Right, so. nailed back together. Looks good. The other trigger swapped out. Wire. Make sure that wire isn't getting stretched when you activate the trigger, which it's not. Looks good. Right, this felt a bit mushy. We'll see if we can swap that out. Yeah, this one feels a lot better. Let's get rid of that. Let's give it a clean. See how shiny they are, which isn't great. Just a piece of notebook paper, firm pressure, and just do a line a couple of inches long, usually enough just to knock the shine off those contacts. Good enough. Right, let's clean these gooey buttons. go, looking good. That's fine. That's sticky, that the paper towel is sticking to it. Right, that'll do. Like the buttons should be able to drop naturally. If they don't, then that means that there's still some sticky stuff on there, but they should just fall completely naturally. If not, get back to cleaning. Like this one, which has got a piece of tissue stuck to it. That's fine. Go. Put the cleaned rubber back on. Get these wires out of the way. It's probably worth checking the board. Clean. Get rid of these backstops. Okay. Hold that together. No need to screw it in. These feel much better compared to the last one. Right, let's get that nailed in. Make sure the buttons are still correct. And check again. Yep, all good. Put the backstops back in. Sync button. LBRB. Okay. click correctly, and they do feel good. Put the D-pad in, give it a clean. Now if you look at the shape of that, this side is slightly shorter than the other three. This one goes down. Short one goes down. Hook it from the bottom, press the top on, job done. Excellent, so that's that section done. Before we forget, let's get rid of all the schmoo out of here. There we go, all clean. Looks like someone's been having a go at this. See, the potentiometer has been pulled away. Also, it's missing the grey clip. See, we've got a grey clip here. That's to retain the L3 function. It's missing off this one, so the stick travels a lot more compared to this one. Plus that's all knurled up, that's a bit gnarly that is, plus it's coming away. Let's have a look at the rotor. That's okay, but either way, let's get it replaced. God, that's the solder from a factory. That is awful. Go again, nice even heating. Gonna have to heat up more on this side because you've got two layer PCB plus this metal can likes to soak up the heat. Again, just an even distance all the way around. Concentrate here a little bit. just gently pull on the analog stick, and as soon as the solder goes molten, the module should drop out. There we go. Hot air is going to go nuts. The area a good clean. Get rid of that bit of melted plastic. This board is burning my fingers. Never mind, who needs fingers? Another analog stick. Make sure it's fully flush. Just do the two anchor points. Keep it in place, because if you need to do any adjustments, it's a lot easier to do when there's just two anchor points. Oh, wrong ones. That one, two anchor points soldered than all four. And then check that it's flush, and it is. For now, just solder up the joints. Usually start with the anchor points. Plastic in that then. I'll do. Mess about with that all day long, doesn't make much difference. As long as it's soldered, it's soldered. Can't be any worse than the Microsoft soldering that we saw earlier. Make sure it's all clean of flux. No clean flux, so it could be left on the board, but just sticky goo everywhere. Get rid of it, don't need it. Properly soldered, flush to the board. Alright, so let's get on to calibrating. Okay, so as you can see, right is off by 22, which is the X, so that's plus 22, 21. Then we go left, come back, it's still plus 4, it should be 0. Or within 5%. As you can see, we're 19 on the X plus, which is right. So, just turning the pad around so I can hold it easier. So we're down to 12, which is good. 11, 12. Still at 12. But now we've gone minus 7, which is... Yeah. Okay, we're at plus 6, minus 5. And that's perfect, that is. That'll be perfectly fine. Nudge it left, and it rests at minus 5. Nudge it right, and it rests at plus 6. Perfect. Y, which is up and down, so up, it rests at plus 4, down, rests at minus 1. That stick is perfect. Right, on to assembly. Actually, let's just test we've got full travel first. So, put the caps and the cover on. Get two sticks. Plug it in again, because I keep forgetting. Hold everything down. 100%. 100%. 100%. And 100%. So the left stick is still good. 100%. 100%. 100%. And 100%. No jitter. No messing about. Perfect. Right, now we can continue with the assembly. Audio socket. Get rid of that. Audio socket's in. Get the board screwed down. Okay, screwed down. Let's twist these wires up so it looks nice and neat. These plastic tabs forward so they hold the rumble motors in properly. Spooge up the pads. And solder them on. That's that done. Get rid of the flux. Same for the other side. Fold the wires in. Sure the two boards are pressed together correctly. Check the buttons. Profile select switch. All the buttons feel good. Rear case. Ribbon cable done. Battery terminals. Bend them back slightly. Not too much. Make sure they're actually inside the shell. Easy to do that. Just double check that. Push the triggers in and press the case down. When it's home, the audio socket is flush. Triggers feel good. Let's give it one last test before I actually put a screw into it. A lot easier to take it apart now than it would with all the five screws in. Analog, perfect. Right analog, perfect. Triggers, I mean bumpers, work perfectly no matter where you press. Sync button clicks. Xbox button, yep, that works. Start and select, perfect. And they were really mushy before, they just felt like there was nothing there. Now they have a nice positive feel. D-pad, perfect. L3, R3, perfect. All the buttons, just the slightest press and it activates. Check the rear buttons. That's going to be a profile. Switch to profile. Ooh. We have no activity on these buttons, which I'm sure we did before. That's not good. This is why we test. See if we can get this off without taking the front off. Come on. Yeah. That looks like it's properly in there. Let's just try that again. Perfectly level. I could have swore these were working fine before. I've just pressed the B button. Happened there. Ooh. That doesn't look right. Okay. So profile one, nothing set. Profile one, nothing set. Profile two, rear buttons are set. They're not working. Paddles not enabled. Double tap the connect button on the top of the controller to turn paddles on and off. Didn't know about that function. Double tap the connect button. Is it that? Ah. And the pad rumbled as well. Huh. Don't know if you can hear that. That's a good feature. So when I was testing that, I must have turned it off and on. Okay, learn something new every day. Right, so they're disabled. Let's get them both. Get them both on here. So you can actually see what's going on. Right, there we go. So, it says there double tap. One, two. Disappears. Click on the tester. There we go. They're working. Never knew about that feature. Had me worried then for a second. Right, let's screw her back together. Check if that right trigger is binding again. Looks like a nice gap. Same as that side. Look at that, buttery smooth. There we go.